So here is what's referred to as an audio spectrum. And at the top up here, that's a waveform. That's the actual signal coming in. That's voltage as a function of time going into a speaker. And what this is this is what's referred to as a audio spectrum short-term Fourier decomposition. Basically, you've got low-frequency stuff down here, high-frequency stuff down here, with time going that way. And the question is, that's a sound. What sound is that? Obviously, it's the song spectrum. It's the spectrum of the prothonotary wobbler, or warbler. Obviously, I'm not a bird person, okay? There's a picture of one. But the idea is, if you listen to this bird chirp, and then you process it over time, or actually, if you listen to it chirp over time, and you process it, you would see this audio spectrum. And the spectra of different birds, of course, are different. Here's two different birds, the prothonotary warbler and the chestnut-sided warbler. But what you can see is that the spectra are really quite different, right? And the goal is to think about these things as what's referred to as time series, and how would you distinguish between them? So for a given time series, there are questions you can ask, like, which bird is this, okay? So you've got an audio signal. Which bird is it? How long is this thing going to keep going? Is this bird sick? Right? That is you know, somehow not normal. And are there different sort of elements or different phases that the bird has? And when you think of these in a time series context, which bird it is, that's a classification problem. Time series classification. How long will it continue? Might have something to do with prediction. Is this bird sick? Would be an outlier detection. And finally, you get a notion of segmentation. So that would be for like bird data. Well, how about other time series data? Here's some. So, you know, here's stock data of different types of indices over different amounts of time. And you might have questions that you would ask, like, will this stock go up or down? Something we all want to know. What type of stock is this, right? If you had a set of categories of stocks. And is this stock behaving the way it normally does? And that becomes just like we saw before, prediction, classification, or outlier detection. Here's another example. Suppose you were listening to the audio of this music, right? So not looking at the imagery of the score of the music itself as shown here, but actually listen to somebody playing it. You might ask things like, you know, is this Bach or Beethoven, which would be classification? Can we make more of that? That's now a generative model kind of question. And computer music people are always interested in listening to some music. Could I have a machine produce more music of that sort of type? And can we sort of divide this up into segments? So this is what's referred to as time series segmentation. By the way, this bottom one is... segmentation has received a lot of attention lately, something called conditional random fields being applied to. We're not going to talk about that. We're going to talk about Markov models. But I just wanted to point out that you might not use what we're going to learn today so much for segmentation as much as you would for some of the classification things.